For over 20 years, the Ruperalia Group had successfully turned a small local bank into a formidable and reputable banking institution until last year, when Bank of Uganda took over the management of the bank after its capital had fallen way below the 50% legal requirement under the law. On Friday, the central bank officially announced it had transferred the liabilities of Crane Bank and conveyed its assets to DFCU Bank.
Investors who came in did not qualify. One of them who was nearing that wanted to do a management consultancy. That for them they want to continue to manage Crane Bank and Bank of Uganda put in money, but that's not what our bid was saying. And so DFCU had ticked all the boxes.
According to Stephen Kaboyo, a banking analyst with Alpha Capital, the takeover was inevitable after Crane Bank accumulated 500 billion shillings in liabilities.
When you look at the performance of banks in 2016 actually, it was such a challenging year because of what was going on in the economy generally, low economic activity, a lot of headwinds. First half of the year was characterized by high interest rates.
On the 21st of August 1995, a Ugandan business tycoon known as Sudhir Ruperalia started one of the most successful banks, which is just right behind me. As we speak, it has collapsed and has crumbled. It will now display a new logo of DFCU. The central bank confirmed that the transfer of ownership would not have an effect on ongoing investigations into why the bank went into insolvency.
There was a loss, okay? Now, what do you do? You have to ascertain how this loss came up. And how do you ascertain this? You carry out a forensic investigation because you want to know, one, why the loss, who caused the loss, and what course of action should you take in case you find out there were persons. So this has numbers as well as legal implications.
However, a look into the financial status of DFCU could present huge concerns ahead of its recent acquisitions, as their 2014-2015 report indicates a decline in profits after taxation from 42 billion in 2014 to 32 billion in 2015, though the percentage of revenue to profit increased from 2014 to 2015. Around this time last year, DFCU was trading on the Uganda Securities Exchange at a price of 950 shillings, while now it's trading at 760 Ugandan shillings, indicating a decline in its share price by 190 Ugandan shillings in just a year. On the bourse, no deals today were closed with a bid of only 7 shares, a clear indication that the DFCU counter was dormant. The board of directors issued an announcement. We quote an excerpt as follows. Accordingly, shareholders of the company are advised to exercise caution when dealing in the company's securities.
By and large, DFCU, in my view, has a very good track record. They are pretty well capitalized.
Currently, DFCU has 4 major shareholders that seconded its decision to take over Crane Bank in its ambitious drive to dominate the financial industry. Rabo Development, a private equity firm from the Netherlands, and Nor Finance, owned by 4 Norwegian private investors, both hold 136,594,923 shares each, which represents 55.8% shareholding. Commonwealth Development Corporation holds 75,580,276 shares, representing 15%. And the National Social Security Fund holds 29,487,658 shares, representing 5%. The 4 investors hold 75% of the company's stock. Andwarinitwe, NTV, Kampala.